This is Music Piracy. It takes place every day and is done with some never knowing. Music piracy is the copying or downloading of music without the consent of the owner.
Hi, I'm Polo. I have an IQ of 170, but enough about me. Let's continue on about music piracy. Music piracy totals $12.5 billion in losses for the music industry. This is calculated from the Institute of Policy Innovation using a mathematical method from the U.S. Bureau of Economic Analysis. The main protection on music is copyright. Copyright laws make it so that you have to have a license fee in order to use someone else's music. The fees depend on what you're going to use the music for. So now, let's go see our friend over here.
Oh, hello there. This music piracy stuff is really interesting. Let me show you something on the board if you don't mind. Let's get started. I'm Nigel McKee, the economics guru. I'm going to show you supply and demand curve of music piracy. This is the equilibrium. This is where it's socially beneficial. This is where we currently are with our protections on music. Despite what the industry says, this is the optimal level for society. But with the protection that the music industry wants, it'll only benefit them, which is right around this point, right up here. With the protection the music industry wants, they essentially create a monopoly, which is not beneficial for society, which creates deadweight loss. Now, this little triangle right here is called the consumer surplus, and this big old rectangle right here is the producer surplus. The deadweight loss is the total loss to society. From this graph, it shows that any more protection on music will create a music monopoly, while still trying to stop music piracy, but far from all of it. On to the next graph. Welcome back. Sorry I had to switch locations. This graph shows with the music industry's viewpoint of music piracy. But first, let's go over here and see what this point represents and what this point means.
Two.
Now, this point on the chart shows the market outcome of music piracy, with a large quantity of music being listened to at a low price.
Hi, I'm Tanner Black. Let's return to our hardworking student, Mr. Chung. Mr. Chung has a big exam tomorrow and is listening to music to help him focus. However, the music that Mr. Chung is listening to is downloaded off a website that illegally obtained the music, which does not compensate the artist whatsoever. Mr. Chung is now involved in music piracy. We can see a similar case of this in the Napster case. This case was between a company called Napster and A&M Records. Napster was an early peer-to-peer file sharing network which could be used to transmit various files. However, it attained its popularity through its ability to share music through MP3s. Obviously, A&M Records did not enjoy this and took it to court. The main issue addressed there was whether it violated fair use.
What is fair use?
Great question, my friend. I'm glad you asked. Fair use is the copying of copyrighted material for limited purposes. Examples include commenting upon, criticizing, or parodying a copyrighted work. In the end, the court decided against Napster because even though there were no sales taking place, they decided that the platform allowed for repetitive and exploitative copying, which was a main point against Napster. Today, we see a similar issue in the platform called Spotify. Spotify is an online music streaming service which allows its users to listen to music for free with ads, or they can limit the ads for around $10 a month. Spotify is similar to Napster and allows users to easily obtain music. However, Spotify does not infringe on copyright. Spotify does contribute its artists, but it does so by giving them back about a penny per stream, which is usually split between the record labels and the artists. Platforms like Spotify and Napster are one of the biggest reasons why we see a fall in CD sales, which is a much more profitable market for artists. Now, to your favorite person, Polo.
Marco.
Thanks, Tanner, for that helpful information. So our friend Sean, he's guilty of music piracy. What happens to him next? The people in charge of deciding that is the RIAA. The RIAA stands for Recording Industry Association of America. Before 2008, our friend Sean would be taken to civil court and be sued by them. But now, they decide that they will not go after certain individuals because it's inefficient. Instead, they go after big companies that provide internet, which allows people to take part in music piracy. The companies they go after include Comcast, AT&T, Charter, and anybody else that could provide internet to people. They do this because getting more protection is difficult and also very expensive, which is inefficient compared to the court cases. Since getting protection is difficult and expensive, the industry has to look for a new way to compete against music piracy and also Spotify and streaming services. The answer is found with our music mogul, Jay-Z. Jay-Z was fed up with music piracy and services like Spotify that stream music. So he decided to create his own streaming service called Tidal. So he took all his music off all other platforms and put it on Tidal, and he also had many other artists that you can find on all the other streaming services. CD sales dying and streaming services providing little incentive, the future for recording agencies is creating their own forms of Tidal. By doing this, they take their music off other platforms and still retain their protection from other piracy. Though this does not completely stop piracy, it is more efficient than creating more protections that would not be able to work in today's technological age.
Thank you for listening to our video on music piracy. We hope you enjoyed.
Copyright.